In this video, we'll show the basics of the polysolid feature, which can be used to create walls and other shapes. First, where can it be found? Depending on how you prefer to model your BIM, there are a couple of options. You can find it in the application menu, in the 3D solids toolbar, or in the quad cursor menu. Open the quad cursor menu by right-clicking in the drawing area. Polysolid can be found in the model tab. Now let's talk about how the feature can be used. At the most basic level, to create the wall, all you need to do is select a start point, an end point, and provide a height. When you initiate PolySolid, a menu appears on the top right that provides a number of options. Each of these has a default value, but you can easily edit them. As we select them, notice that an input option appears on the command line. We can change the default height of the PolySolids created by selecting Height and entering a new value. Let's draw a new wall. And by hitting the spacebar twice at the end, the default height is applied. If you recall, the first wall was at 10, so it appears the default of 14 that we set was applied. Select Width or type W on the command line after initiating the feature to set the width. Enter the width on the command line to draw a wall or set of walls with that width. Once you enter a new value, it will remain as the default moving forward. Another option is to select two points to define a distance, which will then be the width of the wall. To show how justification works, let's start by drawing a single line. We'll change the color so it is easier to see. When we select justification, the submenu provides three options of left, right, and center. We'll start with center. Don't worry, you can change the justification while creating the polysolids as well. Let's start the wall at one end of the line. Since we selected center, half the polyline is one side and half on the other. Did you notice the black menu at the bottom of the workspace? It informs us that by hitting Control, we can change the justification of the wall. The menu appears each time a polysolid is being created, so there is always the ability to change the justification at your fingertips. Now let's get into something even more powerful. Imagine a perimeter footprint has been drawn that is a single polyline. Initiating polysolid, we'll set justification to left, which makes the polyline the outer edge. Next, we'll select Entity and select the polyline. At the click of a button, we have four independent walls created from that polyline. As you see by default, when multiple walls are created, each is independent. To change that, select Separate Solids and turn it off. Now, when multiple walls are created in a single command, the result is one polysolid, not multiple. A final option when creating multiple polysolids to keep in mind is when you create a closed element, meaning you get back to the start. You will be immediately prompted to set a height for all the polysolids, either using the ability to enter dynamic dimensions or accepting the default height. Now you've gotten an initial tour of the where and how of the polysolid feature. Take some time and try it out for yourself. Then watch some additional basic tutorials to expand the creative designs possible in Bricsys BIM.